Hello, Ranos here, and welcome to episode of Cosmoteer, where we are getting close to the base. I'm going to first try to take care of this bugger who seems to be sitting around down here. So I'll get two Kasur over there. Not exact, Kuroka. Two Kasur will go to that end. And then... oh, there's another defense position. For those, I'm just going to put a Tukasa within missile range. They just have her use her missiles to destroy them. Maybe even a nuke. So let them zero rotate. And then Kuroka will move closer to the edge. To see if I can entice the bugger to come along and fight. Oh, you're an interesting one. Cannons on one side, missiles on the other. So I'm feeling this is its primary side. Oof, that bug is going to be a real pain in the ass to deal with. Yep, that'd be a real pain in the ass to deal with. But luckily, that's not a hostile. So it's all fine. Get a bit closer this away. Oh, there's another ship floating around. That's not what we want. Alright. Let's see if Tukasa can reveal the target. And it says no. Bug is moving away. Neat. How many ships are there on this thing? That's a pain. Yeah, me. I should really move my other ships around a bit. I need to take them all on one-on-one. You know, high chance of survival that way. But one of those is quickly approaching. Guess not. Maybe down here. The Tukasa can get over there as well. Oh yeah. I'm hoping as soon as they get revealed, they'll come out and fight. Don't want to get too close to the base yet. Not until I've taken care of these extra buggers. But Tukasa will be using her missiles, or nukes, to destroy some targets quickly. Oh, come on. Nope. See the targets coming in range? Aren't you an interesting fella? You're a nuclear type. Oh, not a nuclear, railgun. Alright, you're not going to be too hard to deal with, but these might be an issue. Yeah. Target that. Gonna keep running. Deal with that one. Ugh. We're full force on the reactor. Hey. This ain't good. Present. Oh man! It's a bloody! Why aren't the nukes doing anything? Great. There goes Kuroka. This ain't good. Because of that bugger always running away, were they able to properly defeat them? Hopefully they'll stop chasing after a bit. This sucks. Well, this is a bad start. Especially considering the nukes seem to do feck all. Yeah, the nukes just don't seem to be working on anything. It's really annoying. Let's see if we can strike that bugger from behind. Focus on its reactors. Well, its thrusters. Stop it from running. Yeah, let's focus on that. And that, and that, 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 that. And launch the nukes. Nee. Nukes always missing. Yeah. Should have to go back up over here. This is a pain. All because of damn railgun. Too difficult to get to. Nee. How's self-destruct? So this is why I want to deal with the excess ones, or the others first. If I can get rid of the non-rail guns before, well, get rid of the non-rail guns first, I should be fine. Yep, they're just gonna keep doing that. Managed to do quite a bit damage to the bugger. I wonder. If she was to come down this way, she might be able to finish the bugger off. If she would even use her nukes. I have a feeling it's not gonna last long enough. Never mind. The other one's decided to come in and help. Well, I guess back to repairs. Nee. And also to rebuild Kuroka. Wrong button. There. Load ship design. And load. Nice way for that to be built. Able to because they get back for repairs. Well, that's an issue. They're all floating around that area. Try to get one of them to break off so I can take it out. It's not going to be easy. But I might have to go for the pod tactic. Just send in like 20 to 30 pods. Just completely coat them in nukes. Yeah, probably they don't have enough nuclear material for that. This bugger has all the nukes I've got. And I've got to reload her. Well, that's problematic now, isn't it? I just gotta make sure I don't get the bloody railgun first. If I can get the other three ships removed first, they'd be a lot easier. Railgun would be simple to hunt down. What? How am I actually going to separate them? They're staying too close to each other. I think there's really any way to deal with this. Those two are pretty much stuck to each other. Just trying to decide. Yeah, you see they're all bundled up. The nuke tactic's the only way to do it. You're just sitting in a bunch of pods. a distraction. They probably have that bugger wiped out quite quickly, though. Yeah. Unfortunately, they've already eliminated that one, and that's obviously the railgun. And they're coming straight for Kuroka. Just keep going this way. And you go and attack as well. There's a ship there. Straight for that. See, that's eliminated the better. And since you'll now have a target, the nukes will fly. Oh, great, it's a bloody... You know. One down. Stop that there. Hold you in place. Eliminate your core. Eliminate the core. Damn it. This ain't gonna work. Why are the nukes landing? Halt there. Bring this bugger over. Alright, that guy's pretty beat up. Once the bugger's crew gets back on board, target, then target. Hit them with the nukes. And Kuroko go after this one. Straight for the reactor. Oh, you're out of missiles. Made up that one. Yeah, that's not good. Oh. No control seat. Well, I don't normally lose a Tukasa. Bloody railgun. Hey, that's not good. That's not good. I lose a few there. I was hoping on using the remains of the others to fix up. Because that's not happening. That's a pain. They may leave, so she might be able to fix herself up on everything that's floating around here. At least two of those buggers are down. It'll be easier to deal with next time. In fact, they might be busy on Tukasa for a while. Might actually prove beneficial. You know how poorly the railgun's doing. Well, it appears the two ships are still engaged in combat around here. Oh, well, that's that one gone. But I will be eliminating this bugger, then chasing that one down. Since I'll be pushing it away from the base, it shouldn't be too difficult to deal with. So, this group. Well, first, look at that, and that, and that, and that, and that, and that. And straight for that. This group will target these. This group will prioritize the cannons. The cannon cells are just prioritizing the reactor. This lot. Prioritize these two. The reactor. Missiles. Straight for that. Oh yeah, I forgot, this is a bloody rammer. Damn it! Finally, both sides got destroyed. Oy, oy, oy. This is just plain ridiculous. Both ways got destroyed by the damn thing. I have to build a new Kuroka. I don't have any weapons left. Gotta run. There's no way Kuroka can fight that thing at the moment. Hopefully she can get away. Those have to be left behind because keeps getting hit by the railgun. Which is unfortunate. It'll eventually stop chasing because it'll be outside of its operational area. Yep, Kuroka's getting away from it. And unfortunately those guys were lost. Why the hell did they just exit? What's the purpose of that? Everyone's ejecting. Without purpose. What the hell's going on? It is ejected without purpose. At least it's stopping now. Let's go collect the idiots that just jumped out. Why the hell are they down there? Anyway, guess I'll just wait till these buggers are back on board. What's going on to this slot over here? And I don't think I'm gonna bother. Back to base for repairs. They'll completely ring up materials at this rate. I'm on a little bit of a missile shortage at the moment, but this guy's the final one. If he keeps going backwards, he'll push himself too far away from the station to receive any support from it. And I'll be constantly launching the missiles at him. The biggest problem is, I can't reach the bugger! I just have to go full speed ahead. Damn it! It's bloody impossible! How the hell do you catch a bloody railgun? It's impossible to catch a railgun! You have to catch it off guard. Why do all my people exit the damn ship? They're all exiting the ship all the time. I don't get it. There's no damn sense on why they are always exiting the ship. Despite no damage received, they exit. Great. Kuroka's got no way of moving now. Now to create an anti-railgun ship. Christ's sakes. Need over 20,000 designs to deal with all these problems. It's just ridiculous. Yeah, it's just near impossible to deal with this. Yep, an anti-rail gunship has to be designed. One that needs to be able to move at 200 meters a second in order to keep up with that thing. You know what? I'm gonna have to end this one here while I go and design an anti-railgun ship. So annoying. The main thing, it's gotta be ultra, ultra fast. Like 20 large thrusters. Just so you can keep up with the damn thing. And it doesn't need many weapons. Just enough to destroy its damn reactors. And maybe even a railgun of its own. Because I have no materials left to do anything. Everything's gone. All because of this one damn base. Every material that I had is now gone. Plenty of bullets though. That's a bit too because I'm back first. Go mining. But let's see if that's even possible. Took this No, it's not. What a pain. Well, I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye. I'm not done yet. I have already gone ahead and designed a new ship, which we will now build. I'm gonna keep it around because it could become useful in the future. And that ship is... Oh yeah, it's the new version of Tuxa. The Aristoka. Boom. This ship is able to go up to 100 meters a second. While the target ship can only do 80 meters a second. And I don't have enough materials. But that's a problem. I will have to go and collect more crew. No more crew. More materials. Yeah, man. That's a pain in the ass. Well, let's go buy some more uranium and stuff. Alright, that's that done. Now let's first upgrade Tukasa before we move on. First things first. Oh wait, she actually needs more than that for a final next stage. Because we're going to go with the wide one. The railgun in the middle. Not enough height. Well, we'll just see how things go there. Get away. What are you doing? Don't assist the construction, you dumb buggers. I need you to, well, you know, fight. This bugger's gonna take care of the railgun. Wait for all of our crew to return. Well, the Tukasa is getting modified. Is there also the reason why I put all of the ammo away into Otakar? Hey there, buggers. Oh, there's some stuff lying around. Strange. There you go, bugger. I think it's time you head out and found the railgun. But I'm gonna go down here first. Why? To make it go up that way. Because during a test, she took like no damage whatsoever from that railgun bugger, which is pretty good. It was quite helpful that she took very little damage, because she has enough shields to keep herself operational, and she's able to get close enough to destroy the railguns. Because that's going to be her first priority, eliminating the railguns on the bugger. You see, she is pretty damn fast. Not sure why that thruster ran out of power. Swan designed it so she wouldn't run out of power. And the game is gonna lag because of all the wreckage that's floating around here. Which I'm actually gonna clean up once I get into range. Well, once I finish up the railgun. I'll have Tukasa come by and use up all the scrap to finish building herself up. Although I am concerned that I can't find the railgun. Here you are. Eliminate that bugger. After all of the destruction it has caused, it will go down. And focus on that, then that, then that, then that. It's down one of its railguns. You can see it can't escape. And it's eliminated the bugger. And it is out. You see, minimal damage. So, we're going to repair that up. Then, we're going to get Tukasa to fly on out and collect all the wreckage. That doesn't get knocked around. So, I'm going to leave this here and call it loot. But since I have completed my objective of annihilating that pest, I'm going to end this video here. Yeah. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.